Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ShadowFury333, and let's check out that ring. I didn't really look at it. So, look at the stats now. Got 1062 health. I actually did boost. I leveled up Vigor, so I have a bit more health than before. I worked out. I could probably get 25 Vigor, and I'm just going to assume that attunement won't be super worth it. I mean, I might get a couple levels for extra FP, but I don't think another attunement slot's going to come up too quickly. Anyway, so... okay, so Endurance, Vitality, and Vigor go up by 5, which is nice. That gives me an extra 250 health and an extra 13 stamina, which is interesting. And Vitality goes up quite a lot, which means that I have 63.2, which is considerably better. However, Absorption looks like it goes down. Oh, Defense goes up. Right, okay. Vitality increases the Defense stat, but the Absorption stat, I've done a bunch of maths on this. The Absorption stat is much more important. So in this case, it looks like I lose about 8.5%, 8.5 to 9% absorption, which is a pretty big drop. That's actually really substantial. Basically what happens is that everything that I take, right now I'm taking about 80% from most attacks, like 80% of its final adjusted damage. This would be 90% in most cases, or 87 to 90%, which if you look, think about it, let's say, a lot of the attacks coming at me, if they're dealing half my life in damage, their attack rating, like the attack power here, for them, is around 600 or so. So if they're around 600, they're going to deal about 400 damage when you finally adjust it. 450, I don't have the chart on hand right now, but it's somewhere around there. Anyway, I really should link that in the description, probably. It's pretty personalized, but... if someone's interested, let me know in the comments. I'll only link it if someone asks, but I will link it if someone asks. Anyway, it's somewhere around 450 if I recall correctly, when you take absorption into account. And that's the 80%. So if it's 400 or 450, if I take 400 damage from something, and that's 80%, that means that the total amount of damage I would have taken is 500, which means I've taken an extra 50 damage per attack that would have dealt 400 damage, now deals 450 damage. Now, obviously an attack that dealt 200 damage now deals 225 damage, so it does scale, but still, it's something like that. I'm exaggerating a little bit. It's actually a bit less bad than that. It's probably more like 440 from 400. Still, yeah. Basically, I'm getting 250 HP, but if I take what would have been a two-shot, that's an extra 100 damage or so. But it's an extra 250 HP. I'm kind of conflicted because that means my vigor is going to be a lot higher than I would expect it to be normally. Okay, I think what I'll do is I'll use this in place of the life ring. So my health isn't quite as high. Actually, the life ring really helps a lot there too. So maybe I'll use the life ring as well at times. And probably re-equip the Saint's Ring, because that way I can get different spells, and then I can get back to Wrath of the Gods, because I find Wrath of the Gods to be a much more useful spell outside of fighting bosses. Like, in fighting bosses, I don't really find Wrath of the Gods super useful, but otherwise I do. So now I have a lot of health, because of rings. Most rings and embers. Alright, well, why not? What's the worst that'll happen? I die? Wait, what am I doing? I have a walk button. Oh. Apparently it is what will happen. Alright then. That's good to know. Although my health, actually I was a bit more curious, my health unembered. 947 unembered, which was my health embered before, but like I said, I do take extra damage. So what would have two-shotted me at, say, 800 health would still two-shot me. Or not 800, it's like 850. What, say if I was 850, which is between the unembered and embered before, would still two-shot me. So apparently that's, if it is a secret area, there's some item you have to pick up or something. Like, maybe the place where I have to use the gesture, I find an item that I have to equip, or a ring I have to equip, or something. Like, something I have to equip, and then if I equip that thing, Nothing obvious. Okay, well, whatever. I guess I'll find whatever it is I have to equip, and then once I find that, then I guess I'll jump down there and not die, I'm assuming. Tough enemy ahead. Well, I'm still in serious mode. Still have my serious hat on. Not embered. Oh, wait a sec. Okay, that's a black knight. That's fine. What I'm curious about... is there any more enemies up there? Because that black knight there is probably... oh, yeah, there is. There are other enemies up there. Thinking that black knight up there is probably a plant. Because the idea is you'd be going up to fight that. Oh, easy backstab. And then another black knight comes to get you. Get over here. Ow! I can never really time that roll properly. Okay, that... oops. And now you die. There we go. Not so tough after all, are you? I'm going to assume that's the only patrolling Black Knight I have to deal with. I'm going to assume that is not the only Black Knight there, but that this Black Knight is pretty much vulnerable to being backstabbed. Ow. Well, if I, you know, backstabbed properly. Ah. Or kicked. Proper kicking is also good. Oh boy. Please don't hit me. You're relentless. Thankfully, I have a crossbow. I mean, deep protection does bring my my absorptions back up to relatively reasonable levels, so I guess that works. This appears to be everybody. All right, so here's something I find interesting about all this. I've mentioned before how I feel like Dark Souls 3 is a mix of Dark Souls 1 references and Bloodborne references. And this is a Bloodborne reference. Now, of course, the original Firelink Shrine thing was more of a Dark Souls 1 reference, but here we're basically at the old Hunter's Workshop / Hunter's Dream. Like, it's the same general idea. Your starting area, which is kind of in this weird, slightly separated ethereal space, turns out to have been based off of some other place that's a more real place or something. And let me stab you. Thank you, you were kind of getting in the way of my discussion here. Anyhow, this reminds me a lot of that, except in the case of the Old Hunter's Workshop, there is no enemies at all. But then again, going with Firelink Shrine, there were enemies, so a bit of a hint. Ring, Hornet Ring. Hornet Ring was... which one was Hornet Ring? I want to say that was the lady. Who's critical attacks? Yes, Kirin. Lord's Blade Kirin. Ring associated with the Lord's Blade Kirin, one of the four knights of Gwyn, the first lord. Boosts critical attacks. The masked Kirin was the only woman to serve in Gwyn's four knights, and her curved sword granted a swift death to any and all enemies of the throne. So far we have two of the four knights' rings. We have Ornstein's, Kirin's, we'd still need Goff's, and we don't have Artorias's. That is the Hawk Ring and the Wolf Ring, respectively. Hawk Ring increases range damage, I believe, and the Wolf Ring boosts poise, as I recall. Don't know where you'd get those. But I'm really curious if this is supposed to be the Kiln of the First Flame, like, if this is supposed to be back in time, or just, like I said, the real-world area where the Firelink Shrine we're going to is a bit of a dream or a bit of a slightly disconnected from reality area. Because, really, there's a lot of Black Knights, which suggests to me that this is actually... oh, whoops. Oh boy. That this is something like the killing the first flame, because in Dark Souls 1, that's where the Black Knights congregated. Alright, I got time. Okay, that was a risk that that paid off, but wow, was that a risk. So yeah. Is this supposed to be a realer place, like the original place that the Firelink Shrine was templated after, like the Hunter's Dream was templated after the old Hunter's Workshop? Because that's the reference I'm getting right now. Anyway, let's read off the Black Knight Greatsword. Ultra Greatsword, wielded by the Black Knights who wandered the lands, designed to face Chaos Demons. The Black Knights constantly faced foes larger than themselves, and this sword's unique attack greatly reduces enemy poise. Okay, I think we've kind of gotten the idea of Black Knights. Also, holy crap, because I need it. Deep protection, the deepest of protections. Now, also, as a rule, Black Knights respawn. Chaos Blade, that's the Master's Blade, though, isn't it? Chaos Blade, a cursed sword of unknown origin bearing uncanny streaks on its blade. Attacks also damage its wielder. The sword is not unlike a thing misshapen, granted life, but never welcome in this world. In other words, chaos itself. For those of you who aren't familiar with Dark Souls 1, the Chaos Blade you got from using Quillag's Soul with a plus 10 curved sword. Remember, in Dark Souls 1, you actually needed a plus 10 weapon of the same type in order to use a soul. You couldn't just transpose it directly. So that was essentially Quillag's sword. Who was one of the Chaos Witches, one of the people who is descended from the Witch of Izalith, who basically started pyromancy by trying to rekindle the first flame and restart the whole world thing without the world ending, that succeeded? Well, no treasure ahead. I mean, it's debatable whether or not it failed or succeeded, because, I mean, she succeeded at something. She just didn't succeed at her actual goal. Anyway, let's go inside this Firelink Shrine, or Erzatz, or Realer. I'm not sure what kind of Firelink Shrine this is, but let's go inside anyway. I need to warm my hands. Be wary of fog wall. Is this a boss rush or something? Oh, maybe it's be wary of fog wall because of the Firelink Shrine. You have that thing where it loads the outside area separately. Am I? No, I'm not. Actually, I want to go longsword. Actually, what I want to do... I've got more than enough... Oh, wow. Got more than enough vitality for it. I mean, the vitality has increased my equip load enough that I'm not in any way concerned. I can keep the hat on. I think I will, actually. I mean, it's not... I don't know. I take the hat off sometimes, and I think it looks a bit better. I mean, there's... It does show off the nice hair. I think it's a rather stylish bun. But at the same time, with the hat on, there's... You know, it's a certain seriousness to it. Like, no, somebody means business. I have an officer hat on. Or something like that. See, the one reason I'm not sure if this is realer or not is because, as you may have noticed, the sky is pitch black. Now, one thing that's a common theme in Dark Souls, like, ridiculously common theme, it is the most common theme, so common it is in the title of the game itself, is darkness. And the thing about darkness, especially within the context of the Dark Souls universe, is that it is the inevitable end of things. Like, everything eventually becomes dark. No matter what, everything eventually goes to darkness. Now, we saw that the sun, a while ago, the sun had gone eclipse. There was a dark, essentially it was like a dark sign in the sky. It's like this symbol in the sky. That's basically what it looked like. I didn't really think about that at the time, but it occurred to me later. Anyway, that suggests to me that this is actually in the far future. Because, well, think about it. Why would the sky be dark now when it was lighter before? Illusion is obviously possible. Illusions were canonic. Like, that's a thing that happened. So it's definitely a thing that could happen. But that is an illusion back at the Firelink Shrine we're familiar with. That could be the case. But at the same time, I don't know. Because the other thing about Dark Souls is that it is a game with a convoluted timeline and also a game of cycles. So, and the thing is, Champion Gundyr is probably not after Eudex Gundyr. Like, Eudex Gundyr was clearly infected. Like, there was something wrong that was most likely irreversible. So I seriously doubt that Eudex Gundyr came before Champion Gundyr. I mean, unless we somehow freed Gundyr from the infection by killing him. Note, I'm using air quotes. But I don't see that. It seems like it would be Champion Gundyr, which means this is most likely some point within the previous cycle of darkness. Like, there's a Dark Lord right now. Eye ahead, although... Eyes of a Firekeeper. Well, that's not... That's not anyone I'm familiar with, I don't think. A pair of dark eyes, said to be the eyes of the first Firekeeper and the light that was lost by all Firekeepers to come. He reveals to the sightless Firekeepers things that they should never see. Okay, so I guess we can give this to Rina. Except she'd probably be utterly horrified if we did. Okay. That's strange. Anyhow. I'm still thinking this is a previous Dark Lord cycle. Alright, cool. Let's try Jester. Why not? Close. Where is it? Let's see. Switch to Toast. Oh, hey, what? You're still here. Well, that throws all my in the past theories out the window. What the heck does this do? That was the gesture, right? Try gesture. That's clearly the toast gesture. I don't know. Well, you're still here.
Well, fancy that. A lost lamb wandereth in, with nary a peep from the bell. Well, thou shouldst my purpose know. What can this old handmaid provide thee? To skirt the curse's grasp, tarry not for long. Tis dark for now, and not a soul stirs, but remember, fires are known to fade in quiet. Or perhaps thou'rt captive already, like the poor girl.
All right, she doesn't recognize me, so I'm assuming this is still in the past. It's just the Shrine Handmaid has been around for a while, so I'm guessing that the one we know from before, well, this one, but is probably from the future.
To skirt the tatties orb like...
She'd probably recognize me otherwise. Oh, yeah, and she's got hardly anything, so... Oh, Priestess Ring. A ring engraved with a portrait of the High Priestess increases faith. In Lothric, the High Priestess has long been considered one of the three pillars of the King's rule. The High Priestess also served as the Prince's wet nurse. That's a bit more information than I strictly needed, but okay. Oh, Wolf Knight armor. This is Artorias' armor. Helm of a knight tainted by the dark of the abyss, the twilight blue tassel is damp and will ever remain so. A vanquished knight left behind only wolf's blood and his legacy of duty. The undead legion of Farron was formed to bear his torch, and the armor of these abyss watchers suggests their own eventual end. Yeah, this is the armor of Artorias. Tower key, which I already have, although... I'm guessing that's for gameplay reasons that there's this, because the thing is, look, she has hardly anything, whereas the one I'm familiar with has loads of stuff because I've given her loads of ash. So I'm guessing that while the Wolf Knight stuff is stuff I don't have yet, or I have, but like, I guess it's from before, I'm assuming this is still in the past because we are dealing with someone like, who's
best
I'm familiar with, but not there. But at the same time, there's a soul where Andre should be. Blacksmith hammer, which suggests the future. Metal hammer passed down among blacksmiths of the shrine serves as a strike weapon, but also excels at reducing poise and breaking the guard of a shield. Of course, a hammer's true potential is realized in the hands of a blacksmith. I wonder if I give Andre the hammer that Andre will have something to say about it? I don't know. Okay, the same praise the chest, they're probably referring to Andre, not, you know, something that is a chest with stuff in it. Actually, let's check anything down here. Oh, I did check down here. Yul's corpse, rather, are not here. Obviously, because as far as I'm hypothesizing, that happened afterwards. Actually, I want to go up. I feel like grabbing that item is going to trigger something. You remember the giant of the profane capital? Yeah, okay, so this is still the same Firelink Shrine. Like, can I place the ashes in these? No, I can't. Okay. Oh, I see what they're... Yeah, because this is the Abyss Watchers. So yeah, Farron loyalty and all that. No, Lodhath's not there. Totally absent. Oh yeah, I want to have the torch on because it's really hard to see in here. That's Aldrich. Nope. Lodhath is not here. So apparently Lodhath either came later or this is way later in the future. Oh yeah, that's where the eyes are. So either way you could go to it, it's a secret path. All right. No bonfire ahead. Coiled sword fragment. Okay, that just raises further questions, because then the coiled sword is something that I had to stick in there. And I had to stick it in there. I'm currently on the theory that I'm both right. Like, this is the past and the future. Fragment of the coiled sword of a bonfire which served its purpose long ago. Returns caster to the last bonfire used for resting or to the bonfire used in Firelink Shrine. Can be used repeatedly. Bonfires are linked to one another irreversibly, retaining their affinity long after their purpose is exhausted. Okay, so it's an aged feather from Dark Souls 2. There was the same item in Dark Souls 2. It was the aged feather in that game. You got it in a dragon airy. But it's the exact same thing. Unlimited use homeward bone. I guess we're that late in the game. So then, like, is this coiled sword fragment supposed to be after I... Because, okay, I planted a coiled sword in here at the beginning of the game. But that coiled sword was jammed into Gundyr. And I was kind of restraining Gundyr. Which is why I'm kind of working off the hypothesis currently that this is both the past and the future. Like, that is, this is part of an eternal recurrence. And we basically, like, skipped a track. Like, the record skipped. And we shouldn't actually be able to see this, but somehow we've managed to get through by getting through Osiris, I guess, and past Osiris to what is essentially a previous incarnation and also future incarnation of this area. Like, both previous and future. Kind of curious if there's a way up there, but I don't think so, because the way up there before was the tower, and the tower was not open to me. And there's no bonfire here, so I really don't want to get out of here before I explore everything, but I feel like there's not much left. We already checked the tower, and it's not even prompting me to open the door. Okay, so let's examine the evidence right now. So we have Dark Sky, which could be before or after, like during the current reign of during the reign of a Dark Lord, or well after the flames have faded, like after the events of Dark Souls 3, or before it. That's not really useful. We have the fact that this place is relatively empty, which suggests that it probably was used. The Handmaid's still here, rather lonely, but apparently not too lonely. Which suggests that there's something here, but she doesn't have a lot of items, which suggests the past, because she doesn't have a lot of ash to work with. But that's assuming that she actually can keep using the same ash over and over rather than having it eventually fade from use. However, the other thing is that she has items that I don't have in the main Firelink shrine. And that's weird. But I'm not really sure what to make of that. Maybe it's just that, you know, I bought them and then now she no longer has them in the future. Presuming that Firelink Shrine we're familiar with is the future of this. So I guess more evidence is that that was a Firekeeper over there. Full-fledged Firekeeper, not Irian of Kareem. But then again, we might give her the eyes. And then she might become a full-fledged Firekeeper. And also the... What was the other thing? Oh, right. Lilith isn't here yet. And none of these are here, but their thrones are here. And the thing is, presumably at the end of Dark Souls 3, of the events of this game, I will either become a Lord of Cinder, which in this case I probably won't because I'm doing everything I can in my power to basically reject the fire. But presumably whoever actually links the fire becomes a sixth Lord of Cinder or another Lord of Cinder. And all these Lords of Cinder line up. None of them are, oh, like, Yorm? Yeah, okay. The Abyss Watchers, same thing. Okay. This is still Prince Lothric. Or Holy King. Oh, what? Oh. I gotta check the one in the Firelink Shrine we're familiar with, because that's King Lothric, not Prince Lothric, St. Aldrich of the Deep. And if it's Holy King Lothric in the Firelink Shrine we're familiar with, then my theory still holds, because Lilith is not here. Lilith isn't sitting here. That means Lilith has not come back yet. Or at least that's what I'm pretty sure it would mean. So this seems like it would... And also, like I said, Champion Gundyr is not infected with anything, whereas Yudex Gundyr has that weird goo infection, which seems to be infecting quite a lot of things. Which suggests that it's the past. However, evidence for the future, this coiled sword is broken. Like, the coiled sword in the bonfire has worn out. It's a fragment. So there's not much there's nothing left of it. And also, Andre's not here, but a blacksmith hammer is. Now, unless Andre moved in from the Undead Parish sometime later, or wherever Andre was hanging out in between games, this suggests that Andre's dead at this point in time. Like, we're in the future, and Andre's now dead. And all that's left is their hammer. But at the same time, there's no evidence of anybody else. Granted, they wouldn't necessarily just die here and leave evidence here. They usually don't. All that's left is the Firekeeper. The Firekeeper corpse, which could very well be the Firekeeper we're familiar with from here, which would suggest the future. Although, given all that together, what it could very well be is that the Champion Gundyr fight is in the past, but as we cross the threshold from that fight into here, it's actually into the future. Or, like I said, possibly kind of both, but my guess is into the future. Like, this is... This part is the future, but the Champion Gundyr part is the past. And that door kind of separates the two. But it's really hard to be sure. Well, this is definitely bizarre, but I'm fairly certain that I have explored everything, though I say that knowing full well after rewatching this series, or... I do rewatch this series to make sure that stuff's working fine, sounds good, my commentary's fairly informative, and if not, then I try to improve it for following episodes. And one thing I have noticed is I am a bit oblivious. It's become a bit of a running joke. Or at least, if you guys find it funny, I imagine it's a joke. If not, then it's just annoying, I'm sure. But yeah, I imagine it's become a bit of a running joke that I am just so oblivious. I miss the most obvious of things. Which, it would be fair to criticize me for that, because I do often miss obvious things. And actually, there's another path down here. Like, the places I've gone, if this is like the Cemetery of Ash follow-up section right before Firelink Shrine. Although, on the other hand, erosion, if this is the future, or this section of it is the future, would suggest... Nope, it's still there. still there. Actually, looks like it's got more to it. No, this is about the same. Rolling ahead? I see no reason to roll whatsoever. And no illusory walls, so unless they're talking about getting into a fight. I don't know, looks like I've cleared out the area. I mean, like I said before, Black Knights do respawn, so yeah, that'll be kind of annoying. I was expecting this to be more of a Killing of the First Flame situation. Now, I'll grant that the Firelink Shrine always kind of looked like the Killing of the First Flame, which is partly why I'm thinking past, because Black Knights would have been cleared out. I mean, obviously they would have had to have been cleared out. But then again, maybe it's the Killing of the First Flame if you link the fires, and then this is your kill, and the Black Knights are there for you. And then with Gundyr, it's a new Gundyr. Or resurrected Gundyr, maybe. Maybe. Do I have a key item that seems to suggest that it might be? I feel like this is a thing you give. Yeah, reveals horrors to the Sightless Firekeeper. That's probably you give to Arena. Well, if there's a way down there without dying, like, the only thing that comes to mind is a ring, because the only thing it reminds me of is, yeah, which would be the Crest of Artorias, would be the Abyss. When you're fighting the four kings in Dark Souls 1, you need a ring. And that allows you to access the Abyss, unless that's a DLC entry point, and you're supposed to get the item once they release DLC. Okay, so let's just see the difference, because there's a bunch of candles here, and obviously it's dark. What about Udex Gundyr? What's different here? There's no candles, but also no evidence of candles. These graves look about the same. We already kind of know what's up there. This area is all cloudy and such. Well, I guess the area in the back, it's really hard to tell with scale though, because like, I mean, this is about the same, but lighter. I'm thinking of the area where the Titanite Lizard was. The large Titanite Lizard. That very first one I ever fought. Because that one... that one had an arena that was occupied with two in the future, past, whatever. In the dark version. Well, it's called the Dark World version because I don't know if it's future or past or an alternate timeline or what. Like... the record skipped track, but I don't know what exactly is going on regardless. It's the only way I can describe it. I know it sounds weird, because I've actually never even seen a vinyl record turntable, but yeah, that's the only thing that comes to mind. The closest I've seen is a video disc player, which is basically like a record player except for videos, but it didn't actually get off the ground. It's a failed RCA project. But my grandfather worked for RCA for 25 years, so he ended up taking one home because they gave it to all the RCA employees. That tangent aside, yeah, that's all I'm thinking of is record skipped track. So we're supposed to be on one track of time, or of, except for, you know, being summoned and such, but that's still kind of on our own volition. And then we went through a door and we just popped off to somewhere to the side, or possibly in the past or future. But we kind of popped off, and it looks like this area is about the same... no, maybe a bit smaller, actually, here. But it still looks about the same. I'm still pretty sure they use the exact same geometry. Just different enemies and... a black skybox. Which, I know, I'm getting very meta here, but yeah. There seems to not be a lot different here, except that stuff's tougher. Which could be either. I mean... could be that the tough enemies decayed or just got killed. You know, I went through and killed them, and therefore there are no more tough enemies. Or it could be that there's... actually, one thing I'm curious about now. Because there was someone who I ended up meeting going through here with an ember. There was a... what was it? Oh yeah, the Crystal Witch or whatever it was, I think. It was a sorceress. I ended up meeting through here with Ember. And I'm kind of curious now that I've killed her in the dark world, if she'll pop up here now. Or if she's well and truly dead. I don't know. No sign of Kriemhild. Okay, never mind. No, no Kriemhild. Well, worth checking. Anyhow, I guess the only thing that's left to do is just double check what's going on around the Firelink Shrine I'm familiar with. Also, hey, there's a message in the same spot. Wait, what? Hold on. Is that a dev message? Also, hang on. My jaw is currently slightly fallen open right now. Hang on a sec. Why can I not write messages? Why are messages locked out to me? What the heck? This is strange. Seriously, what happened with messages? That's not supposed to Oh, okay, I can write messages here. But I can't write them here? Oh. Weird. Alright, well, be wary of the past. Actually, you know what? I think it's gonna work here. Be wary of losing sanity. I think it should be fairly obvious what I'm doing right now. Because I'm noticing that these messages are mirrored. I think. So, yeah. Yep! I was right! Okay, that's an interesting point. Messages are mirrored between these two. Actually, now I'm curious about, obviously, the next question. Which should be rather obvious. Okay, let me think. Concept, is there darkness? Darkness has gotta be in here, right? Visions of dark. Do these mirror? I don't really want to go all the way back up to Firelink Shrine because I don't really want to deal with the Black Knights again. But probably if that section mirrors, then Firelink Shrine would also mirror. No, Firelink Shrine wouldn't mirror. That I've already established doesn't mirror because there's a lot of messages there that are clearly very specifically for the Firelink Shrine of the dark world version, the past or whatever it is. The past or the future or the different loop. I'm sticking with Dark World. Dark World Firelink Shrine. Okay, so it mirrors to up to this point. So I guess the next question is, because there's messages about eyes right in front of Irina. And are you guys going to be really that foolish? Okay, cool, whatever. Your funeral. Anyhow, what I want to know, besides what, oh wait, she doesn't have eyes. Is everyone here blind? Because I noticed there's a blindfold on the fire, on the maiden too. Yeah, they're mirrored all right. Yo, what's up?
Oh, please, the little creep.
You cannot take my eyes.
No, I would, although, but if I, oh, terrible.
Man, she's so moe. It makes me sick. Sorry, I cannot stop. If I say she's so moe, I just have to continue the quote.
Welcome home.
Anyway, give eyes of a firekeeper. She might go insane. Yeah, it's worth the risk.
Ashen one, are these?
There are eyes.
Are these eyes? How gracious of thee, Ashen One.
Try not to go insane.
The very things we firekeepers have been missing.
Oh.
Very well, then take.
I see.
Ashen One, my thank that firekeepers are not meant to have eyes. It is forbidden. These will reveal through a sliver of light frightful images of betrayal. A world without fire. Ashen One, is this truly thy wish?
Oh, come on, game! Now! Oh, oh no.
Oh man, this is...
Alright. Alright, now I'm... really curious. I might regret this, but here's the thing. All this stuff I've been talking about, a dark world... I feel like that's what happens if I give her the eyes. Like, it might synchronize the two.
Of course, I serve thee. This will be our private affair. No one else may know of this. Stay thy path. Find lords to link the fire, and I will blindly tend to the flame until the day of thy grand betrayal. Ashen One, the eyes show a world without fire. A vast stretch of darkness. But 'tis different to what is seen when stripped of vision. In the far distance, I sense the presence of tiny flames, like precious embers, left to us by past lords, linkers of the fire. Could this be what draws me to this strangely enticing darkness? Ashen One, if thine heart should bend, kill me, and strip these eyes from my person. I will return as the firekeeper I once was, as it has always been. Ashen One, as it...
I see.
Farewell, Mace.
So...
Ah, how... Ashen, bring me with... Is it not... Ashen One.
Ah, just what neat.
I'm just gonna go with... alternate timeline? That seems suitable. It doesn't look like there's anything...
Yeah, simple.
Yeah, okay, thank you. I've already... talk to you about that. Okay, yeah. This looks like the world as it would be. Ghost of Lothric future. I don't know. Or past. Like I said, I don't know.
Ah, speak free. Oh, Lord. I pray the other. I'll be set.
Okay, as I was saying about the thing is... Oh, I get it. Dark Souls 3 Firekeepers lose their eyes. In Dark Souls 2, there actually didn't seem to be anything lost. Though the Firekeeper you had... might have had a piece of the Dark Soul, the Dark Soul of Manus' soul. So, which, for those not familiar, in Dark Souls 1, there was, well, the Dark Soul is basically the soul of, the souls of humanity. But there was also one big enemy you fought at the end of the DLC, Manus, which I think was Manus, Father of the Abyss, who basically gave you a soul that was Manus' soul that then apparently split up in Dark Souls 2, and that frames the whole DLC and the main game, and I'm pretty sure that the Firekeeper you have, I think she might be also one of the fragments of the Dark Soul. I'm not totally sure. It's not really made totally clear, but basically all of the queens across all the kingdoms in Dark Souls 2 are all, they're all reincarnations of Manus in different ways. Like, they're all chunks of Manus' soul that have been reincarnated. So I'm guessing that the Emerald Herald is no exception. However, in one, they lost their tongues, or at least one of them lost their tongues. The one you're primarily familiar with, Anastasia of Astora, she lost her tongue. If you let her get killed and then recover her, like revive her, she will have regenerated her tongue. Which is a big deal for her. She never wants to speak. Same thing with Dark Souls 3 Firekeepers and looking at stuff. Having eyes. So anyway, with that lore dump, I have to remind myself of something right now. There's just something I have to remind myself of. And trust me, you'll understand in a sec. Right. I must remind myself of this. Be wary of losing sanity. Because what the hell is going on? Anyway, with that rather strange business done? I bid you farewell until the next episode. Or the previous episode. Or episodes from an alternate timeline. In which I'm using nothing but a shield and a spear. And never dodge at all. Until then. Or since then. Have a good night.